So in this video we are discussing about a relay, continuation of a relay concept. In the previous video we have already discussed about a relay. So relay is nothing but an electromechanical device which is also called as a switch. So it is having a three types in our syllabus, that is a single pole, single throw, normally open, single pole, single throw, normally closed, single pole, single throw, normally single pole, double throw, right? So in this particular slide or in this concept, we are trying to understand how actually the driver circuit looks like and what is the usage of the driver circuit in order to support the relay coil in the embedded systems. So if you just observe this implementation, so in the driver circuit, the two important elements are used, that is a freewheeling diode as well as a transistor. So why the name the freewheeling diode? Because so this will be acting as a fuse. So in this particular implementation, we are understanding with the type of single pole, single throw, normally open. So whenever we are energizing this relay coil, the switch will come in contact and it will be acting as a closed path. And whenever we are de-energizing the relay coil, the switch will be open and it will be an open path, right? So whenever we are continuously energizing and de-energizing the relay coil, the voltage may come in the opposite direction, so which may harm or which may damage the other elements that are present in the circuit. So therefore we have to use a freewheeling diode in order to avoid such circumstances. So that is what they are telling here. A freewheeling diode is used for freewheeling the voltage produced in the opposite direction when the relay coil is de-energized. So the freewheeling diode is essential for protecting the relay and the transistor. Most of the industrial relays are bulky and require a high voltage to operate. So in this implementation, do not bother about the load and all. We are just working, or we are just understanding the concept of a driver circuitry in order to support the relay unit in our embedded systems. So to this switch, we are connecting a load here. Let us not bother about what is a load and why actually it is being connected on all those things. So if the relay coil is energized, the switch will come in contact and there is an establishment of a closed path. If the coil is de-energized, then the switch will be opened and there is a creation of open path. So whenever we are continuously energizing the relay coil and whenever we are de-energizing the relay coil continuously, there may be a production of voltage in the opposite direction which may harm or the damage the other components that are present in the embedded system. So therefore, in order to avoid such circumstances, we are using the diodes here, which is called as a freewheeling diode, which will be acting as a fuse in this particular implementation circuit.